It's Feedback Gaming! Welcome back, guys. Ah, so the game crashed on me. The pocket here was too overwhelmingly awesome. The game couldn't handle it, so it crashed on me. Rest in peace. Rest in pepperoni. So let's close this gargantuan pocket. What we got here? We got half a million and 200,000. Holy macaroni. Damn. So this should cause the southern front to be a lot weaker than the northern one. So that's a lot of American troops completely removed. So, and look, there's no troops here. Oh, damn. The AI, I feel like, misjudges stuff like this, you know, and I feel like this is an opportunity to exploit it. Oh, I'm going to do it now. Let's do this. This feels so ferociously dirty, but I'm going to do it anyway. Oh, no! What the hell are you doing? Oh, I've combined the troops by mistake. Oops. In fact, you guys can actually be on this front line. You guys can go here too. Where are you? Where are you? There we go. Alright, so there are a few troops here that shouldn't be here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is it 6? No, it's 7. Where's the last one? There you are. Alright, okay. So now, you guys are gonna go... Ooh, no, no, don't do that, Dave. That would be foolish. And you are gonna go here. Oh, this is going to be devastating. I am so excited for this. Oh, damn. I'm really going to hope the AI doesn't move it. Because I know what's happened here. They've lost lots of divisions in the south. So what they've done is they've chosen to move all their troops from the north directly to the south. I know what they're doing. Alright, organization building up. And when you're ready, crush, kill, destroy. I don't know. It looks like there's a lot of troops here now. Just for a moment, just the smallest moment, it looked like there weren't that many troops here, but now they've all come back. We're pushing into a fort trench here as well, aren't we? Yep. Ah, we had another, like, tiniest window to attack and we lost it. We're making gains. We're chipping off pieces of them. But it's still not an absolute victory as I would have liked. Alright, so I think we might be able to close them in here, which would be nice as well. Can we go here, guys? Ooh, no. Alright, go here. What are we attacking into right now? That's no trenches, no forts, just forests. Forests are actually a good defense for tanks as well. Oh, it's a river crossing too. Oh, they're just filtering more troops in. Oh, I thought we made a break. I thought we made a break, but we didn't. Oh, no, maybe we have. Maybe we have. No, don't you dare, you son of a bitch. Move. Please move. Why? Oh my god, they're flanking us from behind. That's so frustrating. Oh, we actually cleared that province out as well. Now they've come back. Oh man, that was an opportunity for an awesome pocket. The Americans, man, they just keep coming. The production is pretty crazy though. The only thing that's restricting them is their manpower. Militarism. 5%. That's just gonna let them go forever, that as well. Wind them up and they just keep going. Can you stop now, please? Go here. We can't go down because that's crossing a river and it's also tough terrain too. Ah! Damn! We're so close to getting that as well. What is this? Is this mountain? urban. Really? It's urban? It doesn't look like urban. That's hills. I feel in because these divisions are quite big, I feel like we might be hurting ourselves because of the supply restrictions. The supply restriction is causing a reduction of 1.7%. No, that's not, it's them. I really don't want to abandon this. Let's just stop for a second. No, stop. If we sit here, we're taking attrition. But we're building planning bonus up as well. So weird, we pushed into Italy and now they've got it back now. Oh, it feels like every time we take a chunk out of them, they just take it on the chin, you know? They're like, they don't care. I don't give a crap. No, they're putting up an amazing fight. Another drop into Greece as well. Not seen a drop into Greece before. Not the drop behind us here as well. Oh boy. Okay, so where are the main forces? There's a few here. There's 15 and 9, isn't there? This is a river crossing. This is plains, but storm. I feel like I want to puncture here and then go into the forest here. I kind of want to push here too, and this is forest. Alright, attack. Go. Push. I bet we're behind on tanks now. Yeah, we are. I thought we would be. It's because we've been sitting attrition for way too long. Alright, can we make the pocket? Can we do it? Those pocket dreams. Shit, man, look how many troops are here. Oh my god, we did it. Holy damn. I feel like the AI could be building up planning bonus right now, and they could be just stabbing us in the back at any minute. So I'm going to try and make the pocket narrower. They're pushing them from behind. Oh, supply reduction 32%. Damn. This is another god pocket. It's another one. We're taking some bad penalties here too. Elastic defense. Cool. We're going to go for Blitzkrieg. We want to get as much breakthrough as possible. Mining. Anti-air guns. Nope, I don't care. 5 years away. 12 years away. 12 years away. 4 years away. 5 years away. 7 years away. We have run out of things to research. So this is the point in the game between interwar period where there's not as much content in this mod. Don't get me wrong, guys, this mod is full of content, but let me be honest with you, this is a mod about World War One, remember? So don't be surprised if there's a lack of interwar kind of content. Don't be surprised. Ah, damn, that's another monster of a pocket. But still, just a tiny chip off their shoulder. Tiniest of chips. Where is everyone else? Oh, they're here still. This is hills. Yeah, it is. Go here, then go here, then go here. For some reason, they have to go all the way around. I don't know why. Oh, no! This is bad. This is bad. Oh, there was a pocket here that's been closed. That is actually pretty bad now I think about it, because that means they can push into us. This is actually our territory, and they're eating away at our... our own production, because there's a lot of factories around that area. It's very, very built up. Yay! Oh, here we go. This is about 1 million men. Well, just shy of. It's about 800, 850, 900 maybe. Because it doesn't take into account... This is only reserves, this number. It doesn't take into account this. Let's have a look, guys. So this is mainly USA and France. France, 7 million. USA, 8 million. Damn. Alright, we need to bring our forces back and take care of this little minor problem. Minor hiccup. So behind on guns again. What else is new? Oh, we've got them on aggressive again. Oh my god, they're pushing through again! Oh, actually, there's a lot more German forces around here now. So we are actually pushing actually into Chinese land. This is actual Chinese territory here. Ah, they killed our troops. Why are you guys still here? Get out of here. Well, it actually doesn't matter. You guys can fight it out. I don't care. Why are you guys not moving anymore? Okay, Liberty Ethos. Why don't you guys go here? Alright. I'm actually really tempted now to switch onto light tanks. Because the production cost is night and day. So our heavy tank has a production cost of 23. The early light tank has a production of 8. So every one of those we can make a, well, just under 3. Yeah. We'll just say 3, okay. We'll ignore that one production cost. Okay, please. Please. Ooh, nice pocket. Oh, wow, the Indian front. Oh, man. Oh, it never ends. Okay, so... Yeah, those guys are there, I'm aware of that. And you guys are going to attack and be aggressive. Is there some orders here, the reason why they're staying here? No. Guys, back up, please. Alright, can we leave now, please? Is that everyone? Yep. Alright, we definitely need to close this down because there's tons of factories I'm losing here. Defensive bunker. So this is ahead of time by about 4 or 5 years. We're going to do it anyway, though. Production costs 7. Oh, the production cost goes down. Interesting. That actually kind of does make kind of sense if you think about it. So you think the prototypes should be really, really expensive, shouldn't they? If you think about it, the prototypes would be, I don't know, quite pricey in comparison to the other models. An early prototype doesn't have all the kinks worked out and doesn't have the assembly line project all, the assembly line kind of all lined up properly. So, I have nothing to research now. I guess we start researching some ships that we're not going to make. I guess battlecruisers are better than battleships because they're smaller, I suppose. Yeah, I'll make battlecruisers. Hey, we encircled them too. Nice. So I think what's happening is they're dropping behind them, aren't they? All right, that's that done again. Let's try another to do another Italian pocket again. All right, can run away now. Go, go, go. Hang on. Go here. There we go. I didn't assign the order. That's what I didn't do right. Four divisions. Actually, no. I assigned these here. No. Here. And then front line. No. Fallback line. Here. And go back to making the freaking trenches because. You know what? The trenches didn't. No. The trenches weren't the problem. They didn't break through me directly. They landed behind me, didn't they? We got a spare division somewhere. We've got a spare one somewhere. Who's shit? Give me a shitty one. Yeah, he'll do. Go here. And fallback line is on this port. There we go. We won't have that problem ever again now. A lesson has been learned. Learned. 1.17 mil. Should we start producing more? Some more divisions, maybe? Gotta get rid of those Japanese divisions. They're the ones that are the stronger ones. Oh, okay. I thought it was the Chinese puncturing through. It's actually the Germans. Seems the Germans have joined the Eastern Front. That's nice. Oh, no! Oh, man. As I said to you, every time we take a chunk out of them, they just come back fighting twice as hard. Scraping the barrel. It's because we took all their territory. I think that's the natural reaction. The AI sees that they've got no manpower, and their reaction is to make... to up the recruitment law. Convoys. Where's this guy? Oh, he's from the... We'll arrive at this location in 0 hours. What? France, are you scraping yet? No. You are not. Free speech. So we're learning about liberty, guys. Ottoman lesson in liberty. Why are you not moving? There we go. I think I gave him the order a long time ago, but for some reason didn't go through with it. Oh no, losing convoys. Convoys is still just under 200, so for the amount of time and amount of convoys we've lost, I think we've done alright to get to this point. Alright, we build up planning bonus, go. Yet again, we have an opportunity to split Italy in half again so we can do where exactly, as I said before, we can get some more, cut another chunk off them again. Just a tiny little slice. Another little slice off them. Oh, these are not the right guys. Oh, it doesn't actually matter, does it? No, it doesn't. They've not tried to drop on here for a very long time, have they? They were quite furious at dropping on there, but they're not for a while. Liberia. Aha! And also a bit of Spain as well. They're the only parts of Africa that don't have... hello. Convoys. Oh, it's because we're hitting convoys now. Cool. I feel like... No, I don't feel like anything. Oh, that's nice. Nice little pocket. Thank you. You see, When you're playing Hearts of Iron 4 and you're not playing on such a gargantuan scale, you really appreciate the small pockets. But now I see that ball pocket, I'm like, it could have been bigger. That could have been bigger. Never happy. Never happy. Alright, what are we behind on? So, one of the advantages as well. Ooh, we don't need as much steel. Ooh, we don't need as much wood. I think we've gained that from attacking into here. Grabbing territory like this. Okay. Okay, so we said we were going to change onto tanks, didn't we? We're very, very far behind in our tanks right now. I think we'll just get rid of the tanks that we've already currently got. I think we'll just phase them out. So, reliability. We're going to give them more armor as well, but oh, that just defeats the purpose because we lose all the reliability. This makes the armor go up by one. Oh, that is not worth. That is not worth at all. What is the breakthrough on this tank? The breakthrough is 14. The breakthrough on the heavy is 30. See, when it comes down to it, the bang for your buck is the light tank, isn't it? That's the bang for your buck. Heart attack, piercing, pull 0.5. Alright. I want to improve it some more, but I don't want to hurt the, I don't want to hurt the reliability. I much prefer to have the reliability high. See, we can produce one a day. So, when it comes down to it, just for the whole purpose of production, I feel like it's just going to be better off to keep the troops that we've got, isn't it? Ah, shit. Guns, we're really far behind on guns. It's because we're producing more divisions as well. That's the biggest concern. We're behind on the heavies. We're not producing any heavies either. I want to turn off aggressive because it causes them to kind of, I don't know, be really heavy. Put by a big stack here will be pushing into one territory while the other ones will be really spread thin. I don't know what to do now. There's nothing to research, is there? This is the proper interwar. For another 10 years, there's not much to research. This is the actual, official, genuine, 100% thoroughbred interwar. Triplane fighter. I guess we research a plane, I suppose. Oh, I'm really tempted. We've spent almost 4 or 5 years building up our navy again, and I'm really tempted just to put them here. That would be so stupid. Oh, I'm stupid. I'm a stupid person. I'm going to hell. Oh, no. Look how many boats are there. 84 boats. How many boats have we got? No, that's stupid. Please, Dave. I can't do that. I just can't do that. I really can't risk that. Oh, they've done it again. I thought I had the troops. Oh, I guess they must have pushed into me. Maybe they're getting ballsy because they know I've got tanks and stuff now, maybe, I don't know. Aw, man. I feel like we're being, like, chased around the countryside. That's how it's kind of feeling right now. Mountains, I'm guessing. Mountains, mountains, mountains. Yeah, I want to split them in two again so I can make a pocket. That's the decisive plan. And Germany's getting destroyed. Oh, damn. Germany, hold on. When we get our light tanks, we'll be all right. Oh, no. What's going on here? All right, okay. This hasn't worked. So, break these guys off. Go here. Can we arrive in time? Yep. And then convoy it up. Alright, we need to pull off the front line here. 14 divisions. Make a new army. 19 troops. Go here. Yep. Got a general we can give him. Yep. Be careful. Free speech. Abandoned claims on Cyprus, Kuwait. Now that would be very, very stupid. We're not going to be doing that. Befriend the Afghanistanis. Of course. They're our buddies. They're our friends. We can't break this. Okay, that's pointless. Well, we can break it. It's just going to take ages, so let's not bother. The amount of pockets that we've closed from amphibious landings is just ridiculous. Absolute redonkulous. We're just going to close another one now. This is probably going to be as difficult to close as the Finnish pocket. The Finnish pocket was absolutely crazy. I guess I want to push through the laurels here and make a pocket here. I guess what we could do in the same time is we could make some more transports. The only issue with transports is that... Actually, how fast are these tanks? 7.2. That's actually pretty quick. So I guess... So the horse and cart is a production of 3. But it doesn't have as many resources that you need. Alright. So I think it's better to go for the horse and cart, to be honest with you. Just for the sole purpose that the fact that it doesn't require rubber. So in overall, the production is going to be higher. Yeah, I was hoping to clear off this province here or here and divide the two areas of Italy. Then I can push it, run through the south of Italy and make a pocket there. That was my initial plan. That was the plan. I feel like my push into the Netherlands was actually a good idea at the time, but now it's no longer a good idea. Oh, man, I wish we helped out the Germans before we had the chance, but no, the opportunity, that window has closed. Alright. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Convoys. Oh, we got rid of some American submarines. Alright. They've got wrapped around them. We have to close this pocket, that pocket, the one in Africa. So our job right now is pocket stomping duty. That is our number one job title. Alright, building up planning bonus. Superior enemy. Oh dear. This could be the beginning of the end. Because I don't think we could maybe we'd take this on. This is a devastatingly large pocket. Really, really big. Maybe we can do something really sneaky. Yeah, maybe we can do something really, really sneaky. Oh, this is being closed off anyway. This is horrendously sneaky. Supply issues here. Oh, I've not seen that before. I've not seen that in a very long time, put it that way. Those old nightmares of supply issues in that region. Go here, then grab these ports. That is very cheesy, right? You're ashamed of me how cheesy that was. Oh man, that defense is so high. He's a level 8 general as well. Field marshal, actually. Alright, so how are we going to do the next bit? We're going to have to go here, then around here. Battle Cruiser 3! Can we get the next Battle Cruiser? Yes. The next one being 1940. Oh, that was a waste of time. He just cut me off. No, don't do that! Oh man, I wish the AI wouldn't do that. That's so stupid. And you're gonna lose that guy now. Yeah, we lost him. Oh no, he's backed away. That's so cool. It's all good, it's all good. Don't you dare hit my convoy, boy. They're gonna hit that convoy. No, they are. Damn. Yeah, we don't actually have enough power now to push them back. I think we're going to end up losing now. If Germany and Austria falls, then we're pretty screwed. Yeah. Oh no, actually, there's a few gaps for winning here. You mind? Not hitting my convoy, please. You mind? Alright, we made any new divisions recently? Nope. We're actually getting inside of China now. Oh man, this is so devastating because we're so close to beating them up. Please have low national unity. No! 90%! Why? Oh, balls. Okay, so maybe surrendering China is unrealistic, right? Befriend Afghanistan. That actually might be useful. Maybe if we befriend Persia, anti-Persian policy. Doesn't actually do anything other than boost relations, does it? So we're not the owner of the faction though. The Central Powers is owned by Germany, so it doesn't make any difference anyhow. Adult serve. Still extensive. They've got extra 5% as well, so they can go a lot longer and a lot harder than we can. We just lost a division. Tank division, rest in pepperoni. Light tanks. We are pumping those babies out. How many light tanks? Actually, heavy tanks have we got? Heavy tanks. How many? We have 494. Oh, man. It felt like it took us a very long time to get traction on those heavy tanks before we could actually start using them on the field. Felt like we were making them for like 2 years before we could actually use them. We're going to have to pull some more troops off the front line. Germany's holding this quite well, though. All right. We're gonna have to occupy all of the land. Is there a sneaky way that we can make... we're losing on all fronts though, so we're gonna have to control this somehow. No, there's not a way we can cheese this. I think the lack of divisions is really killing us right now. It's we can't pump out guns as quickly as we would like. That's the biggest problem. That Western Front is slowly creeping in. You can tell like the amount of divisions they've got here is nowhere near as much as what they've got. So Germany's slowly getting buckled. They have a lot more divisions on the Eastern Front though, which is kind of good because we need them. We needed them based here for a very long time. What do we need here? We need infantry equipment and tanks. Ha! Suppression. There's a lot of factories there. We can't afford to not have suppressed, so we have to leave that as it is. I need to make a decision on what I'm going to do here. I need to make a decision. So, we are near the end game because it looks like we're losing. We're losing really badly. And we're not closing this pocket any time soon, because this is an unbelievably huge pocket, and the amount of troops in it is just devastating. I'm actually nervous to abandon this pocket, because this means that I'm basically saying that this pocket is going to rule all. So in that case, we're going to have to pull off the China pocket, which was so close to killing China. Okay, Operation Desperation. What we're going to do is we're going to close that down. We're going to move our tank divisions to China, and we're going to give it all into China. We're going to try and devastate China. That is the plan. And in the meantime, we're going to split this troops in half, put them here, and put you guys here too. Oh, this we've got to take care of as well. Fuck. And then you guys go here. Okay, we're going to take care of our own pocket first. Let's do our own pocket first. So this guy's stuck. Oh, these are the guys covering this front, aren't they? So all we need to really need to do is we just need to push them out here and disconnect this area. So in this case, we're going to grab our tank army. Go here and go here. Yep. Okay, that's the plan, boys. This is Operation Last Ditch Effort, and the plan is to simply push our tank army down, disconnect them from the Suez Canal, make another push into them here with the remaining troops, and then when we abandon the tanks and push them to China, and then we're going to try and make a push into China to end China completely. That is the plan anyway. Guys, if you enjoyed this episode, remember to like and to subscribe, and leave us a comment below how you feel things are going. Can you feel tension in my voice? Can you feel it? It's going to be difficult. Thanks for the feedback, guys. Bye-bye.